The Gaon Mivilna, the most genius rabbi of 250 years ago in the whole world, and one of the biggest of all time, and the holiest of all time, went to a motel that there was a wedding over there. And one expensive thing disappeared there. And they didn't know who he is. Remember, in the old days, nobody knew who is who. Everyone had beard, covered their head. There's no Google to check. So the Gaon Mivilna, they suspected him that he stole it. So they said to him, tell me, did you take that thing, whatever it was, silver thing, a gold thing? He didn't answer. So they started to smack him. Hey, you, answer. They're beating him up. Boom, bam, boom. They threw him out to the street. And everyone started to laugh. I remember this entire time, they don't know it's the Gaon Mivilna. And the Chatan also started to laugh. The groom, it's his wedding. Why are you happy? Look what they do to this man. So the Gaon Mivilna, after they beat him up so bad, he said, thank you, Hashem. You gave me the merit to make the Chatan happy. The Sameach Chatan. It's a different way of looking at life. We would say, why did I deserve it? I'm innocent. Why they beat me up? Where is the justice? Ah, ishtabach shemo. Thank you for giving me the merit. לשמח חתן וקלה, it's מצווה חשובה. His student, the Gaon Mivilna, is learning from his Rav Chaim Mivolozhin, is learning from his rabbi. He went with his wife to a meal of חתן and קלה. Something disappeared there also. They didn't know who he is. They came to him and said, excuse me, did you see that? No. They started to beat him up. His wife, he told her when they went on the road, she wanted to come. He said, no, I'm not taking you. So she said, no, I'm coming. He said, okay, I will take you only in one condition. That no matter what, you don't tell anyone who I am. I don't want them to know I'm Rav Chaim Mivolozhin. I promise. When they were beating him up, say, she said to him, don't dare. Boom, say. No, don't say a word. In the end, you know, a wife see her husband is getting beaten up. Some wife will dance according to the music. But she wasn't dancing. She actually felt the pain. And in the end, she said, you're beating up Rav Chaim Mivolozhin. Wow. They all got the shock of their life. This is Rav Chaim Mivolozhin. They went, they fell on the floor, crying, kissing his feet, asking for forgiveness. He sent his wife back home. So you didn't keep your promise. Adios. Why the Gaon Mivilna went on a road and Rav Chaim Mivolozhin went on a road? This is people who didn't want to stop learning Torah for a minute. On the road, it's hard to learn Torah. The answer is exile. Galus, exile. It's repenting your sins. Repentance. Rav Aaron Lev Steinemann, Zecher Tzadik Livracha, that passed a few years ago, older than 100 years old, he said, today in our generation, the righteous people have no need to go to exile anymore. Why? They can stay where they are. What was the purpose of going to exile? That no one knows you. In your town, everyone knows the Gaon Mivilna is the king of the town. Rav Chaim Mivolozhin, everyone knows. But when he goes to a city far away, 10 miles away, no one knows. There's no communication, no telephone, no internet. Nobody knows how you look. So you come to a place, no one knows who you are. And on purpose, you want them to embarrass you. To kill your ego. To make yourself nothing. That's as a part of the repentance. Working on your character. So Rav Steinemann say, today you don't need it. Why you don't need it today? Who knows why? Because everyone embarrass you where you are. So what if they know who you are? Just look at the comments on YouTube, how many people curse you and make fun at you and call you names. And Baruch Hashem, I have a very heavy load. It's getting wealthier by the minute. Another curse, another lie, another story. Baruch Hashem, it adds. So that's wonderful. Why it's wonderful? Tell you why it's wonderful. It's also a good question. It's wonderful. Why it's wonderful? Because in the beginning, when it's beginning, when the first curse you get, it's like a sharp knife to the heart. Then another curse, and another curse. It's like knives. Tuck, I, like this. 1 week, 2 weeks. You get used to the stabbing. Then, at one point, it doesn't bother you so much anymore. Then, you can care less about it. Not even a bit. Then you begin to enjoy it. Why? Because in your mind, you already understand that you have a bunch of dogs that barks at you. When dogs bark, you get offended? No, these people are worse than any monsters. So, it's like a dog barking at you on the street. The question is, when it hurt in the beginning, first year or two or three, obviously it's a wonderful way to erase your suffering and your sins. But once you get used to it and begin to enjoy the show, is it still a productive tool to erase your sin or no, not anymore?
Like you said, like the guy who went on the business trip.
The guy?
Went on the business trip. Same thing.
So according to you, that's it. You don't make the reward. I disagree. Not because it's me. Try to be objective. The reason is because if someone, it took him X amount of years to raise himself to a great level of confidence. Once he has confidence in Hashem, he's no longer worried. Therefore, he doesn't suffer from anything. Whatever happened, he knows it's for good. Thank you, Hashem. Thank you, I'm happy. Thank you. Lost money. Wow, thank you so much. Whatever happened, it's only for my own good. I don't have 1 minute of fear. The question is, does it count as suffering or no? You just lost $1,000 on the street, fell from your pocket. Thank you, Hashem. Wow, who knows what should have happened to me. I know you saved my life. Thank you, I'm happy. Thank you, it's only $1,000, I'm so lucky. I redeemed my life for $1,000. How can I not be happy? The question is, since you raised yourself to such a level, this $1,000 that you lost that doesn't even bother you, is it still a punishment or no?
It took tremendous work to get to a level like
that. Ah, so you get a reward for the work that got you to that level, and you continue to get the reward forever. Where does it say it? I just read it to you today. In the beginning of the lecture, God paid the people like the fruits of their actions. Not their action, the fruits of their action. Meaning you work very hard, what's the fruit? That you no longer worry and suffer. You're happy from everything. You get a reward, just like in the beginning.